We've been exploring the invisible forces that can be found in one small town, and the town has joined in.
Well, should we try bouncing? So on the count of three, we'll do 1, 2, 3, and everybody jump. Okay. And we'll see what happens. Are you guys ready? 1, 2, 3.
This is street science.
All right, everybody, what happens if you stand on the balloons you're holding in your hands right now?
It'll pop.
It'll pop?
Explosion.
Explosion?
Boom.
Boom?
Stretch.
Stretch. Very good. Let's try it. Everybody put your balloon on the ground, and then on the count of three, stand on your balloon with both feet. Y'all popped your balloons. Why'd you do that? Because you put all your weight down on the balloon and the balloon wasn't gonna be able to support your weight. So of course, eventually your weight put enough pressure on the balloon that the sides of the balloon failed and all the air went out this way. Now what happens if we distributed all of your weight evenly over the balloons? Do you think they would still pop?
Hopefully they won't pop.
We might be killing more balloons.
All right, are you guys ready to give it a shot?
Sure.
Absolutely.
All right, coming around to the other side here.
All right.
And can we bring in the table?
Our balloons are boxed in on a 3 by 6 foot sheet of plywood, and on top, an inverted table rests directly on the balloons. Now it's time for our volunteers to test the strength of these balloons.
All right, Riley, go ahead and step up.
So why does this work? The table is the key. It distributes the combined weight of over 600 pounds across all the balloons. And even though it's a small surface area, just 3 by 6 feet, the balloons can handle the small fraction of the weight that each must bear.
For me, it feels surprisingly sturdy and good. I feel supported.
Well, should we try bouncing? So on the count of three, we'll do 1, 2, 3, and everybody jump.
Okay.
And we'll see what happens. Are you guys ready? 1, 2, 3.
The elasticity of the balloons is at about 16 pounds per square inch. So when the bouncing increases the force on them beyond their elasticity, they burst. If we'd left a little more room in the balloons, they could have had a few more jumps. Still, the air supports almost 600 pounds before adding the jumping force, which causes the balloons to burst.
As you can see in the slow-mo, when the weight hits these balloons, they really stretch out.
Not too bad, not too bad.
The balloon experiment, by far the most fun, super interactive. Popping balloons is always fun. It's like blowing bubbles in soda, never gets old.
You all had to put an awful lot of force down onto that surface to even pop those balloons, and you had to shift your weight around and really, really work at it to make them pop. What did you guys think?
It was fun.
The once fragile balloon, a simple thin bag of air, can hold all of your weight as long as we distribute it nice and evenly amongst a crowd of balloons.